Hey everybody, Keith Wilson at the Trombone Shop at Schmidt Music, back with another instrument for you. And today I've got an instrument I've been really excited about. So this is February 2020. One of the big areas of news in the trombone world the past few months has been the move of Joseph Alessi from Edwards to Shires. And so of course, with Joe Alessi becoming a new Shires artist, we have new artist models from Shires. So of course they have a custom Alessi model here, but they also have an Alessi model of their Q series, the introductory, what I consider the introductory level Shires instruments that have become so popular the last few years. So I've been waiting rather impatiently. We finally got our hands on one of the Alessi Q series here. So I'm going to take a play on this so you can hear this in action, and then we're going to talk about this afterwards. I'm playing all of this today on a Bach 5G. So when the word had come out that Joseph Alessi was moving to S.E. Shires as an artist, of course, there was a lot of interest about exactly what his new trombone design was going to look at. Like, his previous model with Edwards, the T396, was incredibly popular. A very, very unique playing instrument. I've done a review on the instrument in the past. It was I found it to be very, very efficient, but I had to really kind of change my approach with how the instrument played. And so I was really curious to see what the Shires take of all of this would be. And so there are a lot of changes. The design of the Alessi model, both the Custom and the Q series here, it's very unique. A lot of interesting things going on here. So it has an 8.5-inch yellow brass bell. This is the 8Y lightweight. So the Model 8 bell is a modified two-piece bell, but with an unsoldered rim. And they made a few changes with the Alessi. It has some special annealing on the bell, and has a little bit of a heavier top to the stem here as well. Both the main tuning slide and the F side tuning slide are gold brass as well as the outer tubes on the hand slide, and it has a yellow brass crook. It's kind of more of the standard, a wider slide design on the hand slide here, and it has a new valve as well that they designed with Joe Alessi. It looks like, I haven't had a chance to pull the valve apart yet. It is a little bit smaller size. The size is more reminiscent of their dual bore valve in a certain respect here. But of course, the big thing is, how does it play? What happens to the sound? This is one of those instruments where the very first note I played, I said, okay, there's something special going on. There is kind of from the get-go, there is an almost butteriness in the response, and especially in the flexibility of this trombone. I found it to have, of all of the Shires Q series and otherwise, I found it to have one of the quickest, not necessarily quickest, but the most stablest responses. One of the things that, you know, I look for in especially a large bore tenor trombone, depending on what it's designed for, but what I found a lot of really great large bore tenor trombones tend to build in just a hint of that weight we want to the sound. So sometimes you can get instruments that almost respond too quick. You're getting almost more sound before you're ready for it. And this is one of those that is not like that, where it does have that, again, it's not a hesitancy, it's just that perfect balance of response. So as soon as you're ready to start playing, it feels like the trombone's ready for you, and you get this perfect weight behind it. Very, very interesting. And again, the smoothness of the response through the registers is really, really impressive. It just glides between the partials. I found, especially in the mid-upper register, from the low tenor register in the staff and getting above the staff, I love the response of color. I found I didn't really have to change how I played at all. It really matched up well with my approach. I thought that it stayed really, really stable in the upper register. There is a little bit of a shift, I think, from soft dynamics to loud dynamics, but in a really, really nice way. I think it does get a little bit of a sizzle out of the upper dynamics, but it's not over the top. It doesn't get really super brilliant and sparkly. It still has a lot of core. And I feel like I can push the sound, but I don't have to push the sound that hard. Again, this feels like a very efficient instrument to me. I don't feel like I have to really work to get the upper register to happen. It just kind of goes on its own, which is really, really impressive, I think. Now, for all of that happening in the upper register, I did find I had to change my approach a little bit in the lower register. And it kind of makes sense with a lot of things that's going on with it. They're trying to balance a very responsive instrument, a little bit lighter weight instrument, but they're trying to put weight in different ways. They're trying to change some of the resonance, playing around with these different materials and some of the different bell designs with this. And so one of the things I found is more like what I experienced with his 396 model. I did have to pull back a little bit on the lower register. It was very easy for me to overblow especially the bottom of the staff, below the staff, and especially on the valve as well. I do feel a little bit more resistance there, but it's not necessarily bad resistance. It's just letting the instrument work for you, I think. When I found where that sweet spot was, it played beautifully. The lower register, the trigger register in particular, has a little bit of almost that bass trombone sound, where it's got a little bit of that growl in it, kind of naturally. Which is kind of nice in a way. It's a little bit different. And I think, with time, I think one could learn to, broaden that out a little bit more and control that a little bit. So it is a little bit different approach. But again, it's not bad. It's just you have to be a little bit more efficient, which is not necessarily a bad thing. Again, what really struck me is I love the playing, especially in lyrical settings, getting to the upper register. Everything slotted so nicely. If you can't tell, I am really impressed. I think this is a fantastic playing instrument. I've always liked the Q series. I've always really liked the Q series for the playability, for the quality, for the interchangeability, all of these great aspects that they brought to the table. I've always liked them. I've always thought that, frankly, they played above where they were priced. I feel like the Alessi's kind of on maybe a different level. I mean, it's not going to be an instrument for everybody. I think it's going to be one of those. I kind of found this with the Q series as well. You have to have a certain level of ability to really get these to play. When I have younger students playing these instruments, typically they don't play very well at all. So you have to have a certain amount of experience with it. But when for that player who is able to get the instrument to work, boy, there is a lot of really, really great stuff going on. So if this plays the way that I experienced here, I can only imagine. I'm so excited to get a chance to spend time with the Custom Alessi as well. I think that's going to be really exciting and something I am looking forward to. So, as always, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, comments, please feel free to leave those below. If you enjoyed the video, consider giving it a thumbs up. If you haven't already done so, consider subscribing to our channel. We're always going to be trying to create new, fresh content that is hopefully interesting for you, and you can find us on Instagram and Facebook. So, thanks for watching, everybody.